Until next time.
Bye-bye.
Hey, Ryan. What are you doing? Finishing a video? No, like, why are you continuing to buy all this stuff if you don't have space for it?
I don't know. I mean, I guess I'll just find a spot somehow.
Somehow? Look around the room.
Well, I don't want to miss out. A lot of these things are limited edition.
I know you don't, but why do you have to cram everything in this one small space?
Wait. How are you doing that? You do realize there's another room, right? Oh, I get it. Is this like one of those things where you're like splitting the video? My hand disappeared, right?
Why don't you just build another display room?
I think you're right. I think it's about time. Do you wanna...
Sure. I'm Ryan the Cyber Hobbit, and in this video, I'm gonna be making a brand new display room. Stop biting your nails. Is this why you always wear gloves?
That was probably stupid, right?
So I wasn't really sure if I wanted to make this video or not, but I found something online and it sort of encouraged me that maybe I could do this. So maybe this can help someone else if you're thinking of making a new display. And let's go jump on my computer and I'll show you.
All right, so for the new display, I wanted four main things. You need to be big. It needs to be relatively cheap. It needs to be modular, because I'm not gonna live here forever. And when I move, I'd like to be able to expand on what I'm building. And it needs to have LED lights. That led me to the Ikea Besta. These are pretty well-known things that people use for making displays. And there are lots of examples of beautiful ones online. For example, here are a few from the Lord of the Rings Facebook group that I really liked. My only issue is that I'm not really sure the best way to arrange them, and I wasn't sure about sizing. Obviously, you can just do the math and figure out an arrangement, but I came across this thing on IKEA's website that is a Besta builder that allows you to drag and drop and plan out how you want to do your arrangement. And it was very helpful for me to just see everything ahead of time before I ever spent a penny. So here is the arrangement that I came up with. Basically a 4x4 display, so 16 units in total, that will hopefully fill up a majority of one of my walls. Also, another requirement that I forgot to mention was that I wanted things to be enclosed to help prevent the crazy amount of dusting that I have to do. So, luckily, IKEA now sells glass doors that I wasn't aware of for their Bestas. Unfortunately, they don't sell 50-inch tall versions. So for the double-height Besta units that I got, I'll have to use two doors to cover them. But it's better than nothing. I think I can live with it.
Now let's talk about price. The Bestas by themselves were $646, but that's just the start. Since I got the glassvic doors for each one, which are oddly more expensive than the Bestas themselves, that was another $692. And unfortunately, the doors don't come with hinges. So that was another $240. And then finally, I got 8 packs of their legs for another $96, bringing the grand total to about $1,800 when you include tax, which I know I said I wanted something cheap, but I doubt you could find another option that's this big for $1,800. Though technically that's still not everything, because I needed to think about lighting. Now I know there are much cheaper options out there, but I'm a big LED nerd, and this seemed like a great time to check out Govee's new M1 LED strips. These are Wi-Fi controlled RGBIC LED strips that have 60 LEDs per meter and also have a real white LED. So, perfect for what I wanted. Now you may be thinking, Ryan, how are you going to run an LED strip through multiple Bestas and also keep it modular? Well, as it turns out, this LED strip can be cut every half meter, so that ends up being the perfect length to place inside each Besta. I'll just have to solder extension cords on both sides of the strip for each unit. Here's a quick mock-up of what I mean. This should allow me to easily plug in each Besta and expand it should I ever want to. I saw a video of another YouTuber named Elite Collector who was setting up some Besta lights, and he gave me the idea of angling each LED strip a bit towards the back instead of just attaching them directly on the top. Also, one thing that I've seen in a lot of Besta setups that I wanted to avoid is that you can see the LEDs themselves. So to avoid that and fix the angle issue, I turned to 3D printing. I designed these brackets in Tinkercad that should allow me to angle the LEDs just slightly, but also provide plenty of cover so I'm not blasted in the face with light anytime I open the Besta door. Since these were long to match the Besta, I had to print them in three pieces and then weld them back together. After that, I did a little bit of sanding and painting until they were a nice and solid piece. After that, I did a quick LED test and then connected the brackets to the Besta with some 3M double-sided tape.
All right, so after about, I'll say 2 weeks of building Bestas, 3D printing, sanding, priming, making my little brackets, soldering, I'm gonna go ahead and turn the light off here. You guys can see what I've come up with. Da, 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 da. Uh-oh. That one's flickering. That one's sort of flickering. That one's green, that one's red, and that one's just barely lit. So what I believe is actually happening, and I don't believe I messed up wiring things, is voltage is sort of dropping. The current and flow is just not able to reach everything correctly. Am I screwed? I believe the answer is no. My solution is power injection, and I'll explain what that is right now.
So, in my circuit, the current has to travel over 120 feet to reach the LEDs on the end. This is just way further than Govee ever intended. To fix this, I have to do what's called power injection. It just means giving electricity a much shorter path to travel to the furthest LEDs. To do this, I had to break out the red and black wires, which are the power and ground, and run a shorter path to the end and the middle of the circuit. So, a little splicing and soldering later, I made a couple of wired forks for the current to flow, and boom, problem solved. The only thing left to do was a little glass cleaning, and I was done. I think it turned out as good as I had hoped, so I'm pretty happy. Yes, there are a few compromises I had to make, like the Master's Collection Dead Marshes is unfortunately covered towards the top. I can still open the doors to see it, but the important thing to me is that now it's covered up and should hopefully cut down on the dust. Maybe I can find someone who makes custom-sized Besta doors, but for now this is fine. I know this was a little bit of a weird video, but hopefully it can encourage someone to do something similar or at least spark some ideas. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. I'll leave you with a little cinematic video of the display. Until next time, bye-bye.